Hi guys, on part two of this video series, we are gonna create a second application here which will connect to the AMQ server and receive the name that has been sent from application one. So currently now we have built application one and also set up the AMQ server. Now we are only left with the application two, which will receive the name from the AMQ server. So let's get to it. So let's create a new application, file new, Spring Startup Project, then again Maven, let's name it application 2, which is the receiver application that will receive the name from the AMQ server. The application that the first application that did send it straight to this application, it sends it through the AMQ server. So jar java com example, let's leave everything as it is. Next, then web, we choose Spring Web, then type Apache. Then we choose apacheMQ, ActiveMQ 5, then next, finish. Then the second application will be created. So let's wait for it to create, so that we could go back to YouTube, our famous place. So it's building, building, building. So yeah. Our second application has been created here, so let's go here, and in the second application you are just only gonna define the service which will receive the message from the AMQ server itself. So let's create a new package. So package, and let's call it service here. So package service, in the service package let's create a new class. Let's create a message consumer service and finish. So the message consumer service has been created. Let's annotate it with add component. Then we are gonna define a single method here which will receive the message from the MQ server. So public void, let's call it listener, which will be our listener string. Then we'll receive the name or message, whichever you'd want to define it. So let's say add JMS listener annotation, which will say destination, and our destination is YouTube. It's the correct spelling, YouTube. Yeah. So let's import the things, and here we're gonna just say system dot out dot print ln. Then you're gonna say the name sent from the queue is the queue called YouTube is then say plus name. So we're gonna display the name that has been sent from our queue, which is YouTube and name here. So let's go to our properties file again. So in our properties file, let me go to the first application and copy everything from this. Control copy, V. So this will be the same things used to connect from the main application, first one. So let's save everything. So let's go back here. So we have just defined the component, a message consumer, defined the JMS listener, which is the destination YouTube bag. And here we're gonna do a system.out.print, a symbol one. So that's about it for the second application. The first one, the first application is already running. So let's just stop it. And let's delete YouTube back here on our MQ server. Let's start the first application again. So the first application is starting, let's see. Application started. Okay, there's another thing that you need to define. So in Spring, every application it starts on port 8080. So this is the default port for Tomcat, the embedded Tomcat inside Spring Boot application. So we need to define another port for our second application. So we are just gonna say server.port is equals to 8081. So our second application will start on port 8081. Okay, is it our second okay, yeah, it is. Yes, it is the properties file for our second application. So our second application will start on port 8081 instead of the default 8080, which will conflict with the first application. So let's start the second application. So let's run as a Spring Boot app. Let's analyze the console. So as you can see, Tomcat started on port 8081. So it means the second application started on 8081 if you'd like to access it. But most of the time, if you are using JMS and ActiveMQ, the backend application are just there just to process data. There are applications that are not tied to the main application. They just process data that has been sent there. So it can be a message, or it can be sending emails, or processing large amounts of data, byte data that you sent as a base64. So let's go to our server here and restart. Since we started our second application, it will automatically register a consumer here. So let's see. So as you can see, a consumer has been registered, which is on YouTube. So a consumer is the second application which will consume the messages from the message queue. So since both applications are up and running, let's just check hover here. Yeah, both applications are running. Let's send the message to the queue. Let's just copy and paste this, close this, then let's go here and let's hit send. You can send anyone. Let's say John now. Let's send John. We are sending John to YouTube. So John is going to YouTube and he'll tell us what's happening in YouTube. So we send John. John is way through YouTube. Here's the confirmation that John has been sent to YouTube. So John has been sent to YouTube, as you can see. Let's go analyze on the console of our second application. So okay, I was doing the wrong thing. Let's analyze the console of our second application, and we need to get a confirmation. Here it is.
So the name sent from Q YouTuber is John. So our second application has received the name John. So YouTuber has arrived at John, not YouTuber has arrived at John. John has arrived at YouTuber. So the second application received the name that we sent through the queue on our first application. So let's go and observe the queue here. So in observing the queue, let me just restart. As you can see, the number of pending messages in zero on YouTube, and the number of consumers is one, which is our second application. Number of enqueued messages, which is the number of messages which were sent, and it was just John, is one. Messages dequeued, the messages dequeued explain the number of messages our consumer took from the messages enqueued queue. So that's about it with the AMQ server. So let's recap on everything. We created our first application. So after creating our first application, we provided a REST controller. So after providing a REST controller, let's wait for it to open. We provided a REST controller. After providing a REST controller, we define the service, which is our service here, provided the properties to connect to the server, then started the server, which was downloaded from MQ, then created our second application here and defined a service which has a consumer and a JMS listener on YouTube, then defined the name here. This is our second application which receives data from MQ. Then also provided the properties files, changed the server port name, and voila, you can send two data to another application through JMS.